with them, so I had to take them off. This here gospel reading today, I can remember when I was young hearing it and feeling so bad for this guy that didn't have a wedding garment. You know, I thought, what if he couldn't afford it? And he's being cast out with his wailing and gnashing of teeth. It didn't seem right. That's because I didn't understand that it was a parable. When I come to understand that it was a parable and that it was about the wedding feast of the Lamb, and it has one point in it. The point is, in order for you to be at the wedding feast of the Lamb, Jesus our Lord, we have to have on our wedding garment. And, you know, when I started reading the Gospels and the rest of the New Testament, I just come to the idea that the wedding garment must be faith. Because in the 11th chapter of the book of Hebrews, it says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. So I figured it must be faith that we're talking about. And then probably about 31 years ago, I bought this commentary. Now, a commentary is a book that explains the different books and the readings in the Bible. It brings them into today's understanding so that we can understand what it means. And this commentary, it said that at that time, kings and rich people, very rich people, would provide wedding garments for their guests. And so not to put the wedding garment on would have been very rude. We can see why he got kicked out. This wedding garment, you know, I knew it had to do with faith. And as I read, I come into this thing that, you know, that Paul says, clothe yourselves in Jesus Christ. That's the wedding garment we have to put on. Clothe yourselves in Jesus Christ. And we do that by accepting his invitation to follow him, by living his ways, his teaching. They're so important. You know, the bottom line here is it is Jesus who saves us. We have to literally clothe ourselves in Jesus Christ. But when I was raised, you know, at the time I was raised, my understanding was that, you know, I would save myself. If I kept the Ten Commandments and I went to church every Sunday, I was in good shape. I was going to heaven. That's what I was told. And I've met a lot of Catholics like that who think that they're in good shape, that they're going to go to heaven, because they keep the Ten Commandments and go to church on Sunday. They think that that's, like myself, they think that's what makes them right with God. But the righteousness of God comes through faith in Jesus Christ. That's what Paul says in his letter to the Romans in the 3rd and in the 5th chapter. Being right with God comes through faith in Jesus Christ. That means having Jesus in our life. It means inviting him into our life. You know, we're invited to this wedding feast, and we've heard that it's going to be rich, juicy food and fine wine. You know, the readings are trying to prepare us for how good this is going to be. And actually, St. Paul says it hasn't entered the mind of man how good it's going to be. I believe that. I do not even try to think about it, you know, what is heaven going to be like? Because I don't think I could comprehend. But I am looking forward to it. So we need to clothe ourselves in Jesus Christ. He's the one that makes us right with God. We heard in the first reading, let us rejoice and be glad, for God has saved us. That's the thing we often forget. It's God that saves us. We don't save ourselves. And that happens through the person of Jesus and what happened on the cross almost 2,000 years ago. That's what saves us, but we have to accept it into our lives. We have to accept Jesus into our lives. And Jesus shows us in the Eucharist where he wants to live. He wants to live in here. Not out there, not up in the tabernacle, but in here. And not just for a few minutes, but day in and day out. That's where we get grace from. St. Paul says to us in his letter to the Ephesians, second chapter, you are saved by grace, working through faith. We think we're saved by the commandments. It says, you are saved by grace, working through faith, faith in Jesus Christ. And this is not from you. It is not from keeping the law, the Ten Commandments. Rather, it is a free gift from God. All you and I have to do is accept this free gift in the person of Jesus. So today, when you come forward to receive Jesus in the Eucharist, invite him into your life to be your Lord and Savior. If you haven't done that, ask him to be with you. Ask him for that amazing grace that saved a wretch like me 38 years ago. That grace came into my life, and it was amazing grace. I didn't earn it. I couldn't earn it. It was just given to